Alright guys, hello, welcome everyone. Sorry, I was just making a quick little thing for my YouTube I can put up later for this build. People have been asking about it for a while. Thank you again for the sub, Spaz. Welcome everybody. Just doing a little Maelstrom action. Brenoir, how you doing? Spees, what's up man? Good to see you guys. Happy Sunday. Oh boy. Dodging the Sauls. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm hitting every Saul in the dungeon. Please give me a wrecking blow crit. Not a single one. The danger zone. This stage, guys, I really don't like it. In fact, I really dislike this stage. I always die to the Sauls just accumulating damage and dots on me. No matter what happens, that happens. Every time. Without fail. Got a little shout out to Roble on that build. Unplanned shout outs. The best ones. Maybe everyone will look at it and say, hey, fix that shit. Why is that shit still broken? He's doing the steam move. Look out for the steam maneuver. Gotcha. Excellent. What's up, it's ninjas? How you doing? Welcome. How am I doing today? Very well. I hope you're all wells. My magic and night play for some reason. Honestly, I think twice born star is good for magicka and stamina. I think it's like the way to go. Twice born, two undaunted pieces, and either agility or whatever the magicka version of those three piece jewelry sets are. I think that build will work. For anybody, anywhere, anytime. Honestly. In PvE, 100%. Because crit is very, very effective in PvE. It's so effective, if you don't gear yourself to it, you may be doing it wrong. That's my opinion, and I'm going with it. I don't know what the Wamasu's doing. I don't think he does either. Pay attention. You might learn something. You lumps. Is that what she calls them? Lumps? I don't know what she says. Going for a ride, and I don't even know what's happening anymore. Please let me break it. Fingers, thanks. You got it. Yeah, I think as far as my armor setup goes, this works for everybody. Any stamina, any whatever. Just from a DPS perspective, all you have to do is sort out your survival, honestly. Which every class has a way to go about survival. Some better than others. Mine comes from damage. Which is nice from a DPS perspective. It's like amp your DPS and you have better survival. There are things to consider in there where that's... where there's issues with that. Come the fuck on. She's having a heart attack. It's an addiction. It's okay. It's going well so far. Don't be a Debbie Downer. Or Downey Debner. I wanted to come make a content for video. That's all. Gotta give the people what they want. Right? I think my crit surge faded. Careful with that. Okay, my crit surge not working still. Gonna die. Close one. See that big crit surge heal? That is what I am talking about. I like to use Vigor a lot in this stage because this boss hits really hard. Crit surging across the room buys you some time in between her hits to kill the adds, which is a desirable thing. Gotta get rid of those adds, the ranged adds. No good. What sets am I using? I just went through it, Dick in a Box. You'll be able to see it on my YouTube. Just went through it. Twice Born Star, 3-piece Agility, 2-piece Molag Kina, Maelstrom Weapon. That's what I'm using. It will be on the tube. For all the boobs. want to run this build. You make it look so easy. I'm sorry. So yeah, for this stage, you just kill the adds. The beginning's pretty easy. You want to kill those balls when you can, or they go invulnerable like that. No big deal. You just have to come back to them in a little bit. Don't let them stack up though, because they keep coming. Here's a new one. Take him out. And just keep making passes at that ball. Eventually his time will be up and he'll be killable. His time is about up. That one just went down. His time's up. Take the adds out first. New ball. Rotate light attacks, wrecking blows, backpedal with crit rush. That's your general DPS combo. Throw in a bow and you can make sure to rebuff all the time. Keep your stam up with heavy attacks. Anytime you get a break with mobs, weave in heavy attacks to recover stamina instead. Make sure you kill stuff every 10 seconds to keep battle rush up. See battle rush down there on my buff bar. 30% more stam regen. That's important. See, heavy attacks on stuff like that. Just get a heavy attack to get some stam back. We have heavy attacks with uppercuts. See how I'm getting hurt, but I don't have crit surge up, so I almost died there because I didn't have crit surge up. That's all that was. Nothing more. I was trying to heal myself and I couldn't. Heavy attacks. Go for the healers first. Kill the ball. Back on the healer. Back on the main. Punt them into your arrows, which just disappeared. See how quickly you can reapply them and switch right back into fighting. I'm trying to kill that ball out of the corner of my eye. Here's another one. We're about to face the boss, so we don't want a bunch of balls up because they do damage. They will hit you when you're trying to DPS. So this will be the boss now. The boss are just going to deal damage. You got to stay inside of him. The climax approaches. Okay, we're just going to stay inside the green circle in this phase and just let it rip, you know? There's a ball on the other side. I'm not overly concerned about one ball because I just want to DPS him as quick as possible. If your DPS isn't really high, you need to manage the adds. You need to kill every ball that comes up. You need to pay a lot of attention to that. I used to have a build that was more survival than damage, but now I found this build is the perfect balance of giving me the survival I need with the damage I want. Okay. Kill that little ball while we're at it. Kill this one just because it's here. You can see when their shield fades. It's just safe to take care of the balls like that. I'm gonna throw Dawnbreaker on him. Kill the sorc ad. He's coming right up. And then we can get right back on the boss actually. Because there's only one sorc ad. After this, it starts spawning more ads. So beyond this point, it does get harder. But I intend to kill it right now. Because my damage is high. If my damage wasn't high, this fight would take longer for sure, and it gets more difficult. So, in knowing that, in amping my damage, I can just rip through it instead. What's up, unknown gamer? Thalm, how you doing? Next up is the ice phase. This one isn't too hard. There's two spots in here that are pretty hard, and they're not in the beginning. The one is when the ice atronarch spawns. That's pretty hard. In fact, it's one of the frightening parts of the entire dungeon, honestly, because a lot of stuff spawns at once, and there's no way around it, really. You just have to take it on. And with a build like mine, it's dangerous. A build that has more defense and stuff that can take that impact, not a big deal. That's not my build, though. I can't take a lot at once. There's a lot of stuff that almost kills me in one hit in here. Including the other part that I'm talking about, which is the one ogre guy, Boar, he does a shatter move that does 17, 18k on me. So I gotta be careful of that as well. I let that thing, the troll, break the ground over there because I was busy talking. It's okay now, but we can't let him break another. They will respawn at the start of each round, so no big deal. Just don't make a habit of that. Get rid of these archers. You do take damage fighting in the water. I'm just healing through it with my crit surge. But it gets worse and worse. You can't stay in there for a while or it gets bad. I'm gonna lay down a trap beast and trap one of these beasts and amp my damage. Oh, you've been trapped again, beast. See, that allowed me to just regain stamina while killing them with an ult and still having ult saved up to use Dawnbreaker. That's what's cool. Ah, shit. See, talking is difficult. I lose sight of the trolls sometimes. But, like, you can use Overload a little bit and then still switch back and use Dawnbreaker for a burst. I think this is the phase I'm... Yeah, this is it. So, this is a little rough. Keep the trolls down. Above all else. Try to keep your healing up. Take out the range. The thing is, the adds are going to spawn now before I kill this guy, which is what's so hard about this phase. I don't get it. It's really difficult. I don't usually play this safe, and I didn't. I was trying to get Stam up. I didn't have Stam going into that phase. And that's what's a bitch about it. Like, if I don't have my Stam up there, I'm not paying as much attention right now. But if I don't have my Stam up, then I'm not going to have a good time when that that second spawn comes. If I have my Stam up on that phase, usually I just blow away the Atronarch real quick because he's really a pain in the ass. He truly is. Like, I'll go for the Archer real quick, and then the other stuff I'll rely on my AoE to kill, except you still have to take care of the troll. So I'll do that. I'm going to rebuff now, so I don't have to worry about it in a sec. And now I'm going to unleash on this guy. He's already dead, pretty much. Like that. See, it's much easier with some Stam. Because now adds come out. Like, this is no problem, but you've got to get rid of that Frost Atronarch real quick. So, here comes the next wave of junk. It's not bad because there's nothing coming behind this one, okay? Just, God, the targeting. Just gotta kill this stuff. Got a crit surge, or crit rush to heal here. Sometimes your wrecking blows just don't want to crit. But we'll be good, like, that's it. There's no, like, boss, but honestly, like, the bosses in here are pretty easy on this phase. That's why that phase I consider to be a little tougher, at least for, like, my style. Going for another bow today, yeah. This phase, start out killing one of the adds, and then I just pound out. Always knock a range out at the start. And then with those guys, if you can take it down to one, that's good. Because if they both happen to hit you with this move, that's the only thing you really got to worry about, that shatter move there. Everything else is kind of a joke. You just pivot around them, and it's all good. Do some heavy attacks, try to get some stam up here. Your heavy attack cleaves. Your cleave with the arrow spray is good. Again, only thing to worry about is this guy's like shatter move he's going to do. Okay. That, right there. This one hits for 17k. Don't want to get hit by that. Okay, that was cool. I got Zenimaxed by targeting. Just pivot and you should be good. Final round. This isn't bad. This isn't a damage race. It's the biggest piece of advice I give the new people doing this. Everything's based off of his health. So once you take him to 90% health, the first adds spawn, these guys. So you can pull off the boss, focus the adds. Constantly do that. Never stand the boss being like, oh, it's a damage race, I gotta do more damage. It's not. Kill the adds. At about 75%, he's gonna break the ice. There you go, 75, he's breaking the ice, get away from him. He glows red, that's the key indicator there. Target the ad, take the ad out. Of course, we gotta take the troll out above all else. Okay. Back on him, the next set of ads are gonna come next. There's the adds. Kill the troll first. Ranged ad next. Rebuff. There you go. Last piece of ice is being broken now. Gonna rebuff. Put stuff here. Kill troll. Dodge the shatter. Okay, all that's left now is one more set of adds. They're gonna spawn when he's at like 30%. There they go, you can hear the war horn, they just spawned. Kill this troll first. Just kill him. No stems are not PvPing today right now. Negative. Why no rally for extra heal? Because I don't need it and I don't have room and I'll lose damage in doing it. I can't afford. I don't have room for it. Evil Hunter on the two-handed bar gives you passive crit rate increase. That's why it's there. If it wasn't there, I wouldn't have as high crit rate on my two-hander. Fingers, you're doing it to yourself again. Yep. Everything's going well right now. It's So for this phase, kill adds. I do this in a very particular way, actually. So there's five obelisks. You gotta kill the horror wars on them to unlock them. When the spiders spawn, you gotta make your way to the glowing things. They actually switch. When it starts blinking, that means it's gonna switch. You have to make your way to the next one. As far as the horror wars go, though, as soon as you unlock all five, it freezes everything in the arena. It's like a free DPS phase. If you kill them away from the obelisk, you can come up and get the thing. It's a venom grenade, and you have to throw it. Now I'm actually going to leave the last obelisk uncovered and save it for when I need it. I'm not just going to do it. Because right now I don't need it. This part of the arena is pretty easy. It's unnecessary. Oh, I hate the night blades in here. Here's the spiders. Just go to the glowing obelisk. You're all good. Here's the spider. These guys you have to prioritize. Don't let them web the obelisks. They're very easy to kill. You just have to be mindful. It's like your number one concern looking around us. The horror wars and the spiders. Everything else is just stuff you gotta kill. Can recover some stamina. Hitting this guy up. Spider's dead. Okay, spider spawn. I always vigor when the spiders spawn. The spiders will deal a lot of damage to you suddenly. Because they move really, really quick. Keep your eyes peeled for the spiders. There he is. Just take him out real quick. Round 3. Still saving my thing. I'll tell you when we use it. There's going to be a big Stam sorc guy that spawns. That's a good time to use it. Spider spawned. Come to the obelisk. In fact, he's going to spawn on this round. Round 3. There he is. That's him. So he's going to spawn. He's going to cast negate because I cast arrows on him. I usually do that early to get it out of the way. Because next I'm going to bring over the Horvor. I'm going to recast this now. And I'm going to lay into him real hard. There's my lockdown. Free DPS time. And the reason I do this now is because what comes after him, when you get him to 20%, two archers spawn. And it's like a dangerous time. Both these guys can hit you, and he can mess with you at the same time. So it's really annoying. So rather than take that risk, I just save my thing for that. Spider spawned. I want to do the obelisk stuff again now. Keep the spiders down. Number one priority. Crit surge faded. There's your Horvor, bring him in, recast arrows, and just focus on the guy. You can weave in heavy attacks with Forceful, we'll kill it with the arrows. And it's pretty easy to deal with them. There's a little spider, he's dead. I hate the Nightblades in here. They blind you and they disorient you. Very annoying. Redo Vigor before you go in for extra healing. See, I can throw down arrows, Vigor, crit rush in, get my health up, and then I have heal over time on top of it. Now here's the next guy you can use it for. I don't find this one to be as bad, because he just wastes his time twirling his hands and casting something that's not even going to hit you. So it's not as bad, but you can use the lockdown again here if you want to. Reason being, I like to save one for the last round, but you don't need to save it as much for the last round. Okay, see, that's why it would have been good to have there. I think my Merciless Charge actually missed because I got blinded. Yeah, they dodged it. Okay. So I got blinded by the Nightblade, by a skill that shouldn't even be in the game, which is one of the reasons I will occasionally rage out of here. I just fucking get really mad. Because I get hit with stupid shit, like an anti-melee skill in an arena that's already scaled to be so difficult for melees by default. And on top of it, they put a skill in the game that was literally taken out because it's not balanced. It's 100% miss rate. Who wants to fucking deal with that shit? This guy just hits you with some disorient, and then he puts 100% miss on you, so I just run away from him a lot. It doesn't last that long, but in critical moments like that one right there, with my build, it fucking kills me. Which I'm willing to accept if there's other things like that in the arena. There isn't, though. What's the counter to shields? Fucking nothing. Okay? That doesn't exist. That's the lack of creativity in this arena that frustrates me. Okay, see how the obelisk was blinking? It means it's gonna switch to this one. Kill this guy off real quick. Then we're gonna pull the Horvore back into our arrows here while we fight this guy. Comes that same wave again. Hopefully the Nightblade doesn't fuck me over here. There he goes. He blinded me. So I'm going to back off a second. Get the spider first. See how I'm burning through a lot of stamina right now? Just dodge rolling. I went through my whole stam bar almost dodge rolling these fucking idiot mobs that I should be able to just go in and kill. But it's dangerous to do that when I could get blinded. There's the blind, see? 100% miss. Everything misses. Except magicka skills. Don't worry about it. If you're a magicka build, you're good to go here. You know. So I'm going to save the obelisk for the last round now. So I'm not gonna kill the guy there. Spider died to my arrows. Here's the last round. I queued up all my buffs as much as I can, and I'm gonna rip into this boss. I'm not gonna take the first Horvore again. I'm gonna save it till she's at about 50%, at which point I'm gonna unload on her. I'm gonna do the fifth obelisk then. You can't wait forever on this boss. Also, kill her out immediately. This thing will slow you down progressively. It gets worse. Get rid of that thing quick. Cycle your arrows on her. Save your ult till it's at 50%. Try to keep your stam up early on. She's at about 50% now. Here comes the spiders. So we're going to be looking for the next Horvore. We're gonna take the next Horvore in. On the obelisk here and lock her down. Get this guy. Get this ad. Ad's gotta go. This thing starts slowing you, you're done. There's our ad. Bring the Horvore in. We're gonna go into lockdown now. Tab target it and focus it down. There's lockdown. Now she's in execute. There you go. That's how it's done. Well played, NPC says. So that phase can be pretty easy for you. Look out for the blinding mobs. Don't get angry by them. This is the most anti-melee bullshit arena ever created by ZeniMax. This is the most imbalanced of all content I've ever seen in my life. It's so one-sided from stam builds, it's almost laughable. So, with that said, this arena ticks me off the most, although I've learned to deal with it very well. As a new player, you will be frustrated if you're a stam build. you will say, help, I'm stuck. Because it's annoying. Not because it's hard. So those little flowers there, if you cross over them, they blow up a poison thing. You can heal them at either side of the arena, east and west here. You see those green glowing pools? If you get poisoned, you run in them to cure. Unfortunately, the poison will kill you in about 1.5 seconds. So, you know, they don't really give you much leeway there. But don't worry, if you have shields, you can last for a few minutes. Probably 20 minutes, 30 minutes, who knows. It's up to you. When this thing spawns, it blows, it pops all the flowers, and then it respawns them. So just wait till it pops, and then kill it. And keep them down. You don't want to have to deal with that shit. Same thing, when archers spawn, at least for Stam Sorcs, you're going to take advantage of your crit rush with crit surge. And you're just going to heal through that shit. Toss up vigor in between when the melee mobs spawn, drive them into your caltrops. Use this as a time to regain stam. I just heavy attack them under the bow. There's our gal spawning the flowers. Take her out. Same thing. Just weave in some uppercuts, but for the most part, you can just heavy attack these guys under your arrow. Get your stam back because they're very easy. Zenimax and its infinite wisdom made the melee mobs like 1/5 the difficulty of archer mobs. Like, this mob right here is useless. It shouldn't even be in here. It's so easy. It doesn't do anything. It's like a pet. It's like a pet's pet. I don't know. It's ridiculously easy. And then the archers that deal the damage have, like, 3 times the health, 3 times the fucking offense. It just doesn't make sense to me. You know, it should be the other way around, but there you have it. Don't worry too much about the melee mobs in here. They are very non-threatening. Wrecking Blow tooltip. I'll show it to you when I'm out of here. I can't stop in the middle of this fight, though. Here you go. There's your 4 guys. Just drop the arrows and your caltrops and lay in some heavy attacks with Forceful. Pop of Vigor if need. That's the most damage you've ever done to me. Okay, my stam's full, so I can get back to letting it rip. You want to keep your stam high for the times that matter. Now watch it. There's the poison. The poison hit me. I pop a pot. You have to save your pot for it. If I didn't pot there, I would have died. That's how quickly that will kill you. That's why I save my pot in this arena, and I do a lot of heavy attacking. Is there's mechanics like that that screw you. This guy's dangerous, by the way. He's not to be fucked with. He does a lot of damage over time on you that you probably don't realize. He's doing a lot of dot damage. I drop arrows, and when he does this, you gotta roll backwards and avoid that. That thing will, like, one-shot you, that attack. He doesn't do it non-stop, so once he does it, get back in on him. Now back, there we go, roll again. Now back in on him. If that poison hit me, I swear to God. Okay. He also slows you a lot, so yeah. Just deal with that shit. Kill her now. Pop a pot now. It's still the beginning of the round. I'm just going to catch up on my stam. Because I had to use a lot of my stam on that Wamasu. Poison gal's up. Okay, this is a 3 archer stage. Pretty rough. Make sure you roll a lot here, run vigor, make sure your crit surge is up. Try to focus them down. If you ever get hit like that, you go below half. Crit rush to another, just knock her down and go back on another. You basically just want to drop their DPS as needed. And watch out for take aim. It takes a while for take aim to go off though, so it gives you a lot of time. It's almost like a break from taking damage. This is kind of tough too. This is right after the 3 archers. I'm going to use my pot now. Tab target one and take him out quick. He's going to go in rage. which is why you want to drop one and not hit both of them at the same time. Let him rage and back off a sec. His rage is up. He's enraged now. He went big mode. Okay, he's dead. Let's heal up. Let's drop the poison person. Now we can go back on this guy. Just one of them won't kill you, but two of them do have the potential to burst you pretty hard. When he's doing this right there, you can't hurt him. Just gotta wait that for a sec. That does damage and slows you a lot. It's like getting hit with jabs over and over. So watch out for that. This is the last phase. An interesting one too. This one is bugged in many, many, many regards. Some of them are being fixed with the next patch because I've complained a lot about them. And ZeniMax has watched me do this a lot. So this is one of the things that's at least getting fixed. Okay, so two adds spawn. As soon as they spawn, you have to drop one, and you go hide under the other. You have to be careful of a lot of things in here. First of all, his scream hurts you before that bubble actually comes up. That's one of the things that's getting fixed that I've complained about. Again, if you have a shield stack, no problem. Just shield stack until it actually works. If you're stamina and you don't have good burst heal, you're in trouble. Now, I rely on vigor and crit rush. Sometimes, if I can, I'll crit rush the guy who's putting the shield up just as a way to keep myself alive. I try to save my pot for that as well. But it ticks for 11k. Like, I mean, I survive, you know, not much. Because you also have a dot on you, so you can take two ticks of the enrage and then you're done. You gotta tap out. And that's it. Okay, so now he's doing his thing. I vigored to stay alive. Now we just go on him with overload for a little. He's gonna finish, kill this thing really quick, or else she can actually do some damage to you, because then she'll enrage. So you wanna make sure that dies very fast. Always get rid of that ASAP. I think I got hit by that. Yes, I did. And this guy, he just, that bleed's really annoying. Everything he does is anti-melee. He's very easy to deal with at range. I've learned how to melee him, so I'm going to melee him. Because I just kind of face tank through it. Because I use crit rush so much. And I can kill him quicker. And the quicker I kill him, the sooner I'm out of this place. Here we go. I use Dawnbreaker because I'm not going to need my overload anymore. I plan to kill him by the next time that happens. And if I don't, I'm doing it wrong. See, I got hit by his thing, but I just heal through it. If you CC break that quick enough, it doesn't apply the dot. It's a bug. Don't tell ZeniMax, though. Because I don't want them to fix that shit. Got enough problems holding me back. See, I didn't CC break it in time. Sometimes you can't, though, honestly. Jesus. So there you go. It's a rough arena. It's very tough for melee Stam. But it's very doable. Nude, you son of a bitch. How you doing, man? Welcome. On to the next floor. This one's not bad at all. The tree guys hit hard. This is really just a matter of method. Kill the range. Kill the healers. I know everything that spawns here, so I know what I'm facing. These fire guys will put a firestorm up above their head. Make sure you stun them when they do that. That right there. So you want to crit rush to them, bash them, finish everything else, and then check my reward. Okay, he's, I'm sure it's nothing good. Even though I ranked, what, number 6? Okay. This guy spawned, you gotta kill the pillar. Once the pillar's down, you can hit the boss. Usually I overload them, but I used up all my overload charges on the last boss, so I'm actually gonna have to melee this guy, which is really annoying. He does hit very hard. Keep yourself at 100% at all moments. Because he just hits really hard. That's all there is to that. Okay. Three little spiders spawn here. The ranged guy here. Once you learn things, it helps if you actually end up having to do this arena that much and you know every spawn that's coming, like I do, unfortunately. And I still haven't got what I want. So yeah, two healers here. And the adds dish out damage. Make sure crit surge is up. This time I'll have some overload charges to use on this guy, which is nice. Okay, round 3. See, my burst is so heavy, I can just kill through what healers would heal through. If you do this on some builds, you'll be like, man, my damage sucks if you've watched this. Because believe me, I did this and my damage wasn't this high before, and I had a very good build. It's just, this one is very good. I couldn't see myself doing this in any other way now. I really like this build. Especially with a Stam sorc. Gonna rebuff real quick. Yeah, there's the overload proc. Makes your the Molokina proc. It makes your overload cost more, so you get like less shots. But it really doesn't matter. Especially for the way that we're using overload. We don't use it all the time. The only time we do use it, we want to amp up our damage. Again, it would be better if overload was fixed and worked for Stam sorc and it scaled very high. Because then when if I did use it the way I am using it now, Stam sorc would do this. It would have the best DPS, better than Magicka sorc, and it should. As far as I'm concerned, it should. That mob is bugged. His targeting is all goofed. I'm pretty upset that kill one of these guys quick, or they'll both uppercut crit rush you. Kill the pillar to unlock the boss. Kill his healers, and then just range him. She's gonna do a standard. When she drops that standard, make sure you block, because she's gonna try to pull you in. Once you do that, you're good. Just backpedal her with either overload or whatever you want to do. She's not that vicious. I'd consider the trees more deadly. The only thing is the standard. You have nothing else to worry about here. This is the final stage. All three pillars, you have to kill them, and then it frees up the boss temporarily, where you can do DPS. If you don't kill these quick, a lot of adds spawn. Every time, the cycle repeats. So if you can kill these really quick, like I just did right there, the adds don't spawn at all. We're gonna have no adds this first round, which is terrific. Allows me to get in some damage early on. This round adds will spawn because I've slowed down my DPS. Just because I can't keep it up. I don't have the stam to let it rip like I did the first round. See the adds spawning back there. I almost did it in time to where he wouldn't. I usually just let him do what he wants until he does his fire thing, which he didn't even try to do. By the third time, she's going to start doing a wave attack, which is deadly. I'm going to die here, I think. Whew, that was close. I knew he was going to do that fire shit. I'm going to have multiple adds probably now, because now I'm really, really behind. And I'm just out of stamina, unfortunately. God, of course he would do that now. The other adds aren't too bad, although they're coming. I'm going to try to pile them all and Dawnbreak them. Of course you would do this again. Problem is, I just missed all my DPS in the boss. So don't get hit by this. This is like the Valkenscoria shit. From City of Ash. Just kill this. Make sure I have enough stamina to get and bash that guy. Which I'm gonna have to do. Now focus the boss and just down it. That's that. That is the 8th floor. The next one's the last one. So here we go. This one is really tough at first. A lot of the adds are not tough, but try to use your arrows as much as you can. This is where stuff like arrows is really nice. Having that damage right before they spawn. Like, watch how much I use arrows here. I use it religiously because the added damage allows me to kill a target before he can get up and do something, which is really important. Squeeze heavy attacks anytime you can. At the end of rounds, try to recover stamina. These guys, try to put up vigor if you can. The best way to fight them is to backwards wrecking blow and then immediately crit rush into them, light attack, wrecking blow, crit rush. And the reason is it gives you guaranteed crits to survive. If you don't do that, his fire will just kill you instantly. He does a lot of damage, those guards. They absolutely demolish stam builds. They demolish magic builds too, honestly. They do a lot of damage. They're gonna get nerfed, I'm sure they will. But with that said, you can deal with them very well with crit surge if you play like I do with this build. They won't even cause you much issue. Beyond the normal, you're out of stamina issues, which is anytime, all the time. I'm going to use this explosion. Anytime you have the explosion up against the crematorial guard, do it. In general, those guys spawn in such a sink that if you pick up every ghost, you should get them right when you need them. If you miss them, basically you miss the window that they intended you probably to use it. That makes sense. I am fucking out of stamina here. So I'm gonna do a lot of heavy attacking on this punk. On top of it, my crit surge faded there. That was a little dangerous. Never let your crit surge fade. In a fight, it'll end you very quickly. With this build, you're relying on it 100% to heal. Focus. crit surge that got me through that. I just healed a lot from crit surge. If you can ever kill the Nightblade, do it. With this build, you can pretty much kill whatever you open on. This guy sucks. This is like fighting a Magicka DK in PvP right now.
Son of a bitch.
I want to save the Spectral Explosion actually for the next stage, not this one. I don't know if I'll have time to, but I'm going to try. Fuck. Souls reset. This is going to be really hard to do this stage without that. It's a Nightblade, a Crematorial Guard, and this caster that I'm having to waste time with. I might be fucked, yeah. I was one rush away from getting through that. I'm not even sure I had crit surge up there because I feel like I didn't heal much of anything there. But no worries. It's just because... That's what happens. Again, if you don't manage your stam very well and you get to a stage and you have no stam and it's a hard stage. Basically, I collected the souls too quick or I got to that point too slow. And I don't think I got to it too slow, per se, because I moved through these stages pretty quick. Although that one stage I did fuck around on too long, the Ogrim. See, right now, I think I have two ghosts, so I want to collect a third ghost, have it for the next stage. I should get the third ghost right here. Focus the Ogrim, and a third ghost will spawn for this ad here. Here it comes. I missed it. That's fucking swell. So if I had got that, this stage would be a cakewalk, which it won't be now. So instead, I'm just going to Dawnbreak. That should be enough to get me through it. Sometimes you just gotta drop the Dawnbreaker. Never forget Dawnbreaker. Especially in this, everything's Daedra. So this one has summoner guys. You can take them out last. You can stop them with Wrecking Blow. It doesn't look like it, it's just bugged. And it doesn't display properly. Not a great place to use that skill I just used, but it doesn't really matter because this whole stage is a joke. They don't really spawn anything that's dangerous at all. This is the closest thing to it, is this stage. Not actually sure I have crit surge. Now I do. So backpedal with Wrecking Blow and crit rush. The crit rush is what healed me there. Don't let this thing summon. Otherwise, you deal with a big skeleton. I'm just gonna use this because I can. Because I'm not gonna use it next round. Alrighty, we're getting, I think this is Ash Titan round. This is the hardest part of the whole dungeon, or of this level, maybe the dungeon, but if you actually know what to do, it's not the hardest part of the dungeon at all, and I'll explain it to you, because a lot of people that do this dungeon a lot still don't even understand the proper way to do this, so I'll explain it to you right now. What you want to do is get rid of Ash Titan, because Ash Titan is a bastard, he hurts. What you don't want to do is rush through this too quickly. You want to take your time. He spawns adds at 30%. The adds are going to hurt badly. Now there's the stomp. We have to wait for the stomp. I just waited out. I wait for the stomp. Now that he's done the stomp, I'm going to go place everything for this giant burst. So when he hits 30%, which he's about to, I'm just going to unload. There he is. All right, we're going in. And I'm going to hit him with everything. And just get rid of Ash Titan immediately. Because see, these archers spawn and they start doing take aim on you. And you can't see shit. Because the corpse is fucking as big as your screen. But that's how we get through it. Just like that. You gotta take your time. And pace it out. And then you're good. It's very hard for a lot of people. And rightfully so if you don't know what's going on. I didn't for a long time. And I just got through it by sheer luck and frustration. And now that I have that way of doing it, it's no problem for me. This is the last stage. This is the boss. He seems very daunting at first. He's not. He's very easy to deal with. You just have to learn. You have to learn it. It's like a rhythm. Okay? You start the fight out. He's going to hit me with his skull right there. That's what you want to dodge. Get used to dodging that skull. Okay? Now he's going to teleport. I'm going to go to him. I'm going to bash him. Fucking out of Stam. After the bash, I'm gonna go. I'm gonna take his ad out. I am low Stam. I'm gonna drop the arrows back on him. I wanna keep my DPS on him. Okay, dodge this. There's the. That shouldn't have hit me. I'm not even gonna accept that as a realistic death. That wasn't. I was in the roll animation. That's just me getting Zenimaxed, and there's nothing I can do about that sometimes. Okay. It's lag, fucking, I don't know, mega server, you name it, drop the excuse, it's not my fault. There's no fucking way I got hit in that animation. So anyway, same thing. Very easy fight though, once you learn it. It does take learning. So go to him, bash him, go to the ad, gonna uppercut it, gonna reapply my arrows on him. Want to keep my DPS up on him. Focus on the ad. Don't worry about him hitting me. Okay, I'm going to crit rush through that shit. When he blinks, he's going to launch the skull. That's when you have to dodge. Right there, okay? I dodged way early. I had to block it instead. That's okay. Get him to 70% and he goes up. Now he's going up. Okay. Now kill... Before we kill this... We're going to kill this ad first. Because I don't want to deal with this later. You'll have to deal with that later if you don't kill it now. Now take this thing to the platform. There's three platforms around. You got to take it to the one that's glowing. This one's glowing. I kill it there. Now I can use the portal and go up. And this is just a matter of DPS up here. We're going to kill three crystals. He's going to constantly launch those bolts at me. First he launches one, and then he's going to summon this thing that comes around. Now you have soul churn. You see soul churn on the right of my screen? Watch how it keeps gradually going up. You take more and more damage the longer you're up here. So you want to get through this as soon as possible, otherwise you have to jump down and just come up here and finish shit. But I never do that. I just stay up here and I use crit surge. Keep an eye on him out of the corner of your eye. You'll see those things that I dodge. The orbs. Here comes this again. Now what you can do in this phase, make sure you run vigor because the soul churn hurts. You can put up overload and get off some overload attacks. Just don't forget to dodge. You can put down rearming trap and caltrops on one of those, which will do longer damage over time while I focus on this one, which I do a lot. Okay. Now we have one more to deal with. Not sure that I have that up because I wasn't getting healed. Alright, now he's going to port down here. Go to him right away and bash him. He's going to be doing that thing right off the bat. Bash. Okay, the best thing we want to do, we want to keep arrows on him and we want to pick up all the ghosts. We have to take all the ghosts. Beyond that, don't worry about hitting him. Let your arrows run on him. He's going to port around, dodge his shit, kill the adds that come down. Okay, they're your primary concerns. Keep arrows on them, kill the adds, collect the ghosts. Here comes another ad. Don't get too far away from him. Oh god, I'm in trouble. That thing spawned early. Fuck! And I missed the ghost. You missed the ghost, you're kind of fucked. Not gonna lie. I'm really gonna have to go above and beyond, but I'm out of stam. So unless I get lucky with crits, and my stam's not regening, I have better stam regen than that. I regenerate enough stam to crit rush every tick, and fuck, I don't know what was happening there. I should have been able to get a crit rush on that guy. I'm very familiar with my my stam regen, but whatever. Shit happens. Shit is so inconsistent sometimes, I don't know what the fuck's going on. My guy was probably stuck in a block animation or some shit. Same shit. Just do this. There's a good crit. If you get a wrecking blow crit, you can just stay on the guy and up your DPS instead. One too many barrels, but it doesn't matter. I gotta still kill this guy first before I go up, so I don't have to deal with him later. Apply that stuff just to get my stam up. The more you can get your stamina up in here, the better. Remember to heal with crit rush in here as a reliable heal. Same thing, we're gonna charge the boss, bash him, cut off the ghost, put the arrows on him, watch for his necrotic orb, here it comes. Other than that, just try to keep your stam up. Run and fetch the ghost in case that guy spawns early again like he did last time, which he did. Take out the adds, but don't let him get the ghost, get every ghost. Dawnbreak him, kill the add. Can do some damage now on the boss right here. Actually probably kill him right here. Yep. That's it. What's up, Fly Parquet Brown? Fingers, why do you do the arena so much? To get stuff. Fair, how you doing? Sorry, I was talking a lot, guys. I may throw some of that up for video content and for people to see, you know, how it's done and all. Yeah, the arena down to a T, yes. Not the loot. The looting. The looting I'm a little weak on. I get hats of succession that are well fitted. That's going right to the decon factory. Isis said we should have got a Evil Hunter on the two-handed bar gives you passive crit rate increase. That's why it's there. If it wasn't there, I wouldn't have as high crit rate on my two-hander. Fingers, you're doing it to yourself again. Yep. Everything's going well right now. So for this phase, kill adds. I do this in a very particular way, actually. So there's five obelisks. You gotta kill the horrorvores on them to unlock them. When the spiders spawn, you gotta make your way to the glowing things. They actually switch. When it starts blinking, that means it's going to switch. You have to make your way to the next one. As far as the horrors go, though, as soon as you unlock all five, it freezes everything in the arena. It's like a free DPS phase. If you kill them away from the obelisk, you can come up and get the thing. It's a venom grenade, and you have to throw it. Now I'm actually going to leave the last obelisk uncovered and save it for when I need it. I'm not just going to do it. Because right now I don't need it. This part of the arena is pretty easy. It's unnecessary. Oh, I hate the night blades in here. Here's the spiders. Just go to the glowing obelisk. You're all good. Here's the spider. These guys you have to prioritize. Don't let them web the obelisks. They're very easy to kill. You just have to be mindful. It's like your number one concern looking around. It's the horrorvores and the spiders. Everything else is just stuff you gotta kill. Can recover some stamina. Hitting this guy up. Spider's dead. Okay, spiders spawn. I always vigor when the spiders spawn. The spiders will deal a lot of damage to you suddenly. Because they move really, really quick. Keep your eyes peeled for the spiders. There he is. Just take him out real quick. Round 3. Still saving my thing. I'll tell you when we use it. There's gonna be a big Stam sorc guy that spawns. That's a good time to use it. Spider spawned. Come to the obelisk. In fact, he's gonna spawn on this round. Round 3. There he is. That's him. So he's going to spawn. He's going to cast Negate because I cast arrows on him. I usually do that early to get it out of the way. Because next I'm going to bring over the Horvor. I'm going to recast this now. And I'm going to lay into him real hard. There's my lockdown. Free DPS time. And the reason I do this now is because what comes after him, when you get him to 20%, two archers spawn. And it's like a dangerous time. Both these guys can hit you, and he can mess with you at the same time. So it's really annoying. So rather than take that risk, I just save my thing for that. Spider spawned. I want to do the obelisk stuff again now. Keep the spiders down. Number one priority. Crit surge faded. There's your Horvor, bring him in, recast arrows, and just focus on the guy. You can weave in heavy attacks with Forceful, we'll kill it with the arrows. And it's pretty easy to deal with them. There's a little spider, he's dead. I hate the Nightblades in here. They blind you and they disorient you. Very annoying. Redo vigor before you go in for extra healing. So yeah, I can throw down arrows, vigor, crit rush in, get my health up, and then I have heal over time on top of it. Now here's the next guy you can use it for. I don't find this one to be as bad, because he just wastes his time twirling his hands and casting something that's not even going to hit you. So it's not as bad, but you can use the lockdown again here if you want to. Reason being, I like to save one for the last round, but you don't need to save it as much for the last round. Okay, see, that's why it would have been good to have there. I think my Merciless Charge actually missed because I got blinded. Yeah, they dodged it. Okay. So I got blinded by the Nightblade, by a skill that shouldn't even be in the game, which is one of the reasons I will occasionally rage out of here. I just fucking get really mad. Because I get hit with stupid shit like an anti-melee skill in an arena that's already scaled to be so difficult for melees by default. And on top of it, they put a skill in the game that was literally taken out because it's not balanced. It's 100% miss rate. Who wants to fucking deal with that shit? This guy just hits you with some disorient, and then he puts 100% miss on you, so I just run away from him a lot. It doesn't last that long, but in critical moments like that one right there, with my build, it fucking kills me. Which I'm willing to accept if there's other things like that in the arena. There isn't, though. What's the counter to shields? Fucking nothing. Okay? That doesn't exist. That's the lack of creativity in this arena that frustrates me. Okay, see how the obelisk was blinking? It means it's gonna switch to this one. Kill this guy off real quick. Then we're gonna pull the Horvore back into our arrows here while we fight this guy. Comes that same wave again. Hopefully the Nightblade doesn't fuck me over here. There he goes. He blinded me. So I'm going to back off a second. Get the spider first. See how I'm burning through a lot of stamina right now? Just dodge rolling. I went through my whole stam bar almost dodge rolling these fucking idiot mobs that I should be able to just go in and kill. But it's dangerous to do that when I could get blinded. There's the blind, see? 100% miss. Everything misses. Except magicka skills. Don't worry about it. If you're a magicka build, you're good to go here. You know. So I'm going to save the obelisk for the last round now. So I'm not gonna kill the guy there. Spider died to my arrows. Here's the last round. I queued up all my buffs as much as I can, and I'm gonna rip into this boss. I'm not gonna take the first Horvore again. I'm gonna save it till she's at about 50%, at which point I'm gonna unload on her. I'm gonna do the fifth obelisk then. You can't wait forever on this boss. Also, kill her out immediately. This thing will slow you down progressively. It gets worse. Get rid of that thing quick. Cycle your arrows on her. Save your ult till it's at 50%. Try to keep your stam up early on. She's at about 50% now. Here comes the spiders. So we're going to be looking for the next Horvore. We're gonna take the next Horvore in. On the obelisk here and lock her down. Get this guy. Get this ad. Ad's gotta go. This thing starts slowing you, you're done. There's our ad. Bring the Horvore in. We're gonna go into lockdown now. Tab target it and focus it down. There's lockdown. Now she's in execute. There you go. That's how it's done. Well played, NPC says. So that phase can be pretty easy for you. Look out for the blinding mobs. Don't get angry by them. This is the most anti-melee bullshit arena ever created by ZeniMax. This is the most imbalanced of all content I've ever seen in my life. It's so one-sided from Stam builds, it's almost laughable. So, with that said, this arena ticks me off the most, although I've learned to deal with it very well. As a new player, you will be frustrated. If you're a Stam build, you will say, "Help, I'm stuck." Because it's annoying. Not because it's hard. So those little flowers there, if you cross over them, they blow up a poison thing. You can heal them. At either side of the arena, east and west here, you see those green glowing pools. If you get poisoned, you run in them to cure. Unfortunately, the poison will kill you in about 1.5 seconds. So, you know, they don't really give you much leeway there. But don't worry, if you have shields, you can last for a few minutes. Probably 20 minutes, 30 minutes, who knows. It's up to you. When this thing spawns, it pops all the flowers, and then it respawns them. So just wait till it pops, and then kill it. And keep them down. You don't want to have to deal with that shit. Same thing, when archers spawn, at least for Stam Sorcs, you're going to take advantage of your crit rush with crit surge. And you're just going to heal through that shit. Toss up Vigor in between when the melee mobs spawn, drive them into your caltrops. Use this as a time to regain Stam. I just heavy attack them under the bow. There's our gal spawning the flowers. Take her out. Same thing, just weave in some uppercuts, but for the percent more Stam regen. That's important. See, heavy attacks on stuff like that. Just get a heavy attack to get some Stam back. We have heavy attacks with uppercuts. See how I'm getting hurt, but I don't have crit surge up, so I almost died there because I didn't have crit surge up. That's all that was, nothing more. I was trying to heal myself and I couldn't. Some heavy attacks. Go for the healers first. Kill the ball. Back on the healer. Back on the main. Punt them into your arrows, which just disappeared. See how quickly you can reapply them and switch right back into fighting. I'm trying to kill that ball out of the corner of my eye. Here's another one. We're about to face the boss, so we don't want a bunch of balls up because they do damage. They will hit you when you're trying to DPS. So this will be the boss now. The boss are just going to deal damage. You got to stay inside of him. The climax approaches. Okay, we're just going to stay inside the green circle in this phase and just let it rip, you know. There's a ball on the other side. I'm not overly concerned about one ball because I just want to DPS him as quick as possible. If your DPS isn't really high, you need to manage the adds. You need to kill every ball that comes up. You need to pay a lot of attention to that. I used to have a build that was more survival than damage, but now I found this build is the perfect balance of giving me the survival I need with the damage I want. Okay. Kill that little ball while we're at it. Kill this one just because it's here. Can see when their shield fades. It's just safe to take care of the balls like that. I'm gonna throw Dawnbreaker on him. Kill the Sorc Ad. He's coming right up. And then we can get right back on the boss, actually. Because there's only one Sorc Ad. After this, it starts spawning more ads. So beyond this point, it does get harder. But I intend to kill it right now because my damage is high. If my damage wasn't high, this fight would take longer for sure. and it gets more difficult. So in knowing that and amping my damage, I can just rip through it instead. What's up, unknown gamer? Thalm, how you doing? Next up is the ice phase. This one isn't too hard. There's two spots in here that are pretty hard, and they're not in the beginning. The one is when the ice atronarch spawns. That's pretty hard. In fact, it's one of the frightening parts of the entire dungeon, honestly, because a lot of stuff spawns at once. And there's no way around it, really. You just have to take it on. And with a build like mine, it's dangerous. A build that has more defense and stuff that can take that impact, not a big deal. That's not my build, though. I can't take a lot at once. There's a lot of stuff that almost kills me in one hit in here. Including the other part that I'm talking about, which is the one ogre guy, Boar, he does a shatter move that does 17, 18k on me. So I gotta be careful of that as well. I let that thing, the troll, break the ground over there because I was busy talking. It's okay now, but we can't let him break another. They will respawn at the start of each round. So no big deal. Just don't make a habit of that. Get rid of these archers. You do take damage fighting in the water. I'm just healing through it with my crit surge. But it gets worse and worse. You can't stay in there for a while or it gets bad. I'm gonna lay down a trap beast and trap one of these beasts and amp my damage. Oh, you've been trapped again, beast. See, that allowed me to just regain stamina while killing them with an ult, and still having ult saved up to use Dawnbreaker. That's what's cool. Ah, shit. See, talking is difficult. I lose sight of the trolls sometimes. But, like, you can use Overload a little bit, and then still switch back and use Dawnbreaker for a burst. I think this is the phase, and yeah, this is it. So, this is a little rough. Keep the trolls down, above all else. Try to keep your healing up. Take out the range. The thing is, the adds are going to spawn now before I kill this guy, which is what's so hard about this phase. I don't get it. It's really difficult. I don't usually play this safe, and I didn't. I was trying to get Stam up. I didn't have Stam going into that phase. And that's what's a bitch about it. Like, if I don't have my Stam up there, I'm not paying as much attention right now. But if I don't have my Stam up, then I'm not going to have a good time when that that second spawn comes. If I have my Stam up on that phase, usually I just blow away the Atronarch real quick because he's really a pain in the ass. He truly is. Like, I'll go for the archer real quick, and then the other stuff I'll rely on my AoE to kill. Except you still have to take care of the troll. So I'll do that. I'm gonna rebuff now, so I don't have to worry about it in a sec. And now I'm gonna unleash on this guy. He's already dead, pretty much. Like that. See, it's much easier with some Stam. Because now adds come out. Like, this is no problem, but you gotta get rid of that Frost Atronarch real quick. So, here comes the next wave of junk. It's not bad because there's nothing coming behind this one, okay? Just, God, the targeting. Just gotta kill this stuff. Gotta crit surge, or crit rush to heal here. Sometimes your wrecking blows just don't want to crit. But we'll be good. Like, that's it. There's no, like, boss. But honestly, like, the bosses in here are pretty easy on this phase. That's why that phase I consider to be a little tougher. At least for, like, my style. Going for another bow today, yeah. This phase, start out killing one of the adds, and then I just pound out. Always knock a range out at the start. And then with those guys, if you can take it down to one, that's good. Because if they both happen to hit you with this move, that's the only thing you really got to worry about, that shatter move there. Everything else is kind of a joke. You just pivot around them, and it's all good. Do some heavy attacks, try to get some stam up here. Your heavy attack cleaves. Your cleave with the arrow spray is good. Again, only thing to worry about is this guy's like shatter move he's gonna do. Okay. That right there. This one hits for 17k. Don't want to get hit by that. Okay, that was cool. I got Zenimaxed by targeting. Pivot and you should be good. Final round. This isn't bad. This isn't a damage race. It's the biggest piece of advice I give the new people doing this. Everything's based off of his health. So once you take him to 90% health, the first ad spawn, these guys. So you can pull off the boss, focus the ads, constantly do that. Never stand the boss being like, oh, it's a damage race, I gotta do more damage. It's not. Kill the adds. At about 75%, he's gonna break the ice. There you go, 75, he's breaking the ice, get away from him. He glows red, that's the key indicator there. Target the add, take the add out. Of course, we gotta take the troll out. Above all else. Okay. Back on him, the next set of ads are gonna come next. There's the ads. Kill the troll first. Ranged ad next. Rebuff. There you go. Last piece of ice is being broken now. Gonna rebuff. Put stuff here. Kill troll. Dodge the shatter. Okay, all that's left now is one more set of adds. They're gonna spawn when he's at like 30%. There they go, you can hear the war horn, they just spawned. Kill this troll first. Let me just kill him. No stems are not PvPing today right now, negative. Why no rally for extra heal? Because I don't need it and I don't have room and I'll lose damage in doing it. I can't afford, I don't have room for it. As far as I'm concerned, it should. That mob is bugged. His targeting is all goofed. I'm pretty upset that, kill one of these guys quick or they'll both uppercut crit rush you. kill the pillar to unlock the boss, kill his healers, and then just range him. She's going to do a standard. When she drops that standard, make sure you block, because she's going to try to pull you in. Once you do that, you're good. Just backpedal her with either overload or whatever you want to do. She's not that vicious. I'd consider the trees more deadly. The only thing is the standard. You have nothing else to worry about here. This is the final stage. All three pillars, you have to kill them, and then it frees up the boss temporarily, where you can do DPS. If you don't kill these quick, a lot of adds spawn. Every time, the cycle repeats. So if you can kill these really quick, like I just did right there, the adds don't spawn at all. We're gonna have no adds this first round, which is terrific. Allows me to get in some damage early on. This round adds will spawn because I've slowed down my DPS. Just because I can't keep it up, I don't have the stam to let it rip like I did the first round. See the ad spawning back there. I almost did it in time to where he wouldn't. I usually just let him do what he wants until he does his fire thing, which he didn't even try to do. By the third time, she's going to start doing a wave attack, which is deadly. I'm going to die here, I think. Whew, that was close. I knew he was going to do that fire shit. I'm going to have multiple ads probably now, because now I'm really, really behind. And I'm just out of stamina, unfortunately. God, of course he would do that now. The other ads aren't too bad, although they're coming. I'm going to try to pile them all and Dawnbreak them. Of course you would do this again. Problem is, I just missed all my DPS in the boss. So don't get hit by this. This is like the Valkenscoria shit from City of Ash. Just kill this. Make sure I have enough stamina to get and bash that guy. Which I'm gonna have to do. Now focus the boss and just down it. That's that. That is the 8th floor. The next one's the last one. So here we go. This one is really tough at first. A lot of the ads are not tough, but try to use your arrows as much as you can. This is where stuff like arrows is really nice. Having that damage right before they spawn. Like, watch how much I use arrows here. I use it religiously because the added damage allows me to kill a target before he can get up and do something, which is really important. Squeeze heavy attacks anytime you can. At the end of rounds, try to recover stamina. These guys, try to put up vigor if you can. The best way to fight them is to backwards wrecking blow, and then immediately crit rush into them. Light attack, wrecking blow, crit rush. And the reason is, it gives you guaranteed crits to survive. If you don't do that, his fire will just kill you instantly. He does a lot of damage. Those guards. They absolutely demolish stam builds. They demolish magic builds too, honestly. They do a lot of damage. They're gonna get nerfed, I'm sure they will. But with that said, you can deal with them very well with crit surge if you play like I do with this build. They won't even cause you much issue. Beyond the normal, you're out of stamina issues, which is anytime, all the time. I'm gonna use this explosion. Anytime you have the explosion up against the crematorial guard, do it. In general, those guys spawn in such a sink that if you pick up every ghost, you should get them right when you need them. If you miss them, basically you missed the window that they intended you probably to use it. That makes sense. I am fucking out of stamina here. So I'm gonna do a lot of heavy attacking on this punk. On top of it, my crit surge faded there. That was a little dangerous. Never let your crit surge fade in a fight. It'll end you very quickly. With this build, you're relying on it 100% to heal. Focus. It's the crit surge that got me through that. I just healed a lot from crit surge. You can never kill the Nightblade, do it. With this build, you can pretty much kill whatever you open on. This guy sucks. This is like fighting a Magicka DK in PvP right now.
You son of a bitch.
I want to save the Spectral Explosion actually for the next stage, not this one. I don't know if I'll have time to, but I'm going to try. Fuck. Souls reset. This is going to be really hard to do this stage without that. It's a Nightblade, a Crematorial Guard, and this caster that I'm having to waste time with. I might be fucked, yeah. I was one rush away from getting through that. I'm not even sure I had crit surge up there because I feel like I didn't heal much of anything there. But no worries. It's just because that's what happens. Again, if you don't manage your stam very well and you get to a stage and you have no stam and it's a hard stage. Basically, I collected the souls too quick or I got to that point too slow. And I don't think I got to it too slow, per se, because I moved through these stages pretty quick. Although that one stage I did fuck around on too long, the Ogrim. See, right now, I think I have two ghosts, so I want to collect a third ghost, have it for the next stage. I should get the third ghost right here. Focus the Ogrim, and a third ghost will spawn for this ad here. Here it comes. I missed it. That's fucking swell. So if I had got that, this stage would be a cakewalk, which it won't be now. So instead, I'm just going to Dawnbreak. That should be enough to get me through it. Sometimes you just gotta drop the Dawnbreaker. Never forget Dawnbreaker. Especially in this, everything's Daedra. So this one has summoner guys. You can take them out last. You can stop them with Wrecking Blow. It doesn't look like it, it's just bugged. And it doesn't display properly. Not a great place to use that skill I just used, but it doesn't really matter because this whole stage is a joke. They don't really spawn anything that's dangerous at all. This is the closest thing to it, is this stage. Not actually sure I have crit surge. Now I do. So backpedal with Wrecking Blow, then crit rush. The crit rush is what healed me there. Don't let this thing summon. Otherwise, you deal with a big skeleton. I'm just gonna use this because I can. Because I'm not gonna use it next round. Alrighty. We're getting, I think this is Ash Titan round. This is the hardest part of the whole dungeon. Or of this level. Maybe the dungeon. But if you actually know what to do, it's not the hardest part of the dungeon at all. And I'll explain it to you. Because a lot of people that do this dungeon a lot still don't even understand the proper way to do this. So I'll explain it to you right now. What you want to do is get rid of Ash Titan. Because Ash Titan is a bastard. He hurts. What you don't want to do is rush through this too quickly. You want to take your time. He spawns adds at 30%. The adds are going to hurt badly. Now there's the stomp. We have to wait for the stomp. I just waited out. I wait for the stomp. Now that he's done the stomp, I'm going to go place everything for this giant burst. So when he hits 30%, which he's about to, I'm just going to unload. There he is. Alright, we're going in. And I'm going to hit him with everything. And just get rid of Ash Titan immediately. Because see, these archers spawn and they start doing take aim on you. And you can't see shit. Because the corpse is fucking as big as your screen. But that's how we get through it. Most part, you can just heavy attack these guys under your arrow, get your stam back. Because they're very easy. Zenimax and its infinite wisdom made the melee mobs like 1/5 the difficulty of archer mobs. Like this mob right here is useless. It shouldn't even be in here. It's so easy. It doesn't do anything. It's like a pet. It's like a pet's pet. I don't know. It's ridiculously easy. And then the archers that deal the damage have like 3 times the health, 3 times the fucking offense. It just doesn't make sense to me. You know, it should be the other way around, but there you have it. Don't worry too much about the melee mobs in here. They are very non-threatening. Wrecking Blow tooltip. I'll show it to you when I'm out of here. I can't stop in the middle of this fight, though. Here you go. There's your 4 guys. Just drop the arrows and your caltrops and lay in some heavy attacks with Forceful. Pop a Vigor if need. That's the most damage you've ever done to me. Okay, my stam's full, so I can get back to letting it rip. You want to keep your stam high for the times that matter. Now watch it. There's the poison. The poison hit me. I pop a pot. You have to save your pot for it. If I didn't pot there, I would have died. That's how quickly that will kill you. That's why I save my pot in this arena, and I do a lot of heavy attacking. Is there's mechanics like that that screw you. This guy's dangerous, by the way. He's not to be fucked with. He does a lot of damage over time on you that you probably don't realize. He's doing a lot of dot damage. I drop arrows, and when he does this, you gotta roll backwards and avoid that. That thing will like one-shot you, that attack. He doesn't do it non-stop, so once he does it, get back in on him. Now back, there we go, roll again. Now back in on him. If that poison hit me, I swear to God. Okay. He also slows you a lot, so yeah. Just deal with that shit. Kill her now. Pop a pot now. It's still the beginning of the round. I'm just going to catch up on my stam. Because I had to use a lot of my stam on that Wamasu. Poison gals up. Okay, this is a 3 archer stage. Pretty rough. Make sure you roll a lot here, run vigor, make sure your crit surge is up. Try to focus them down. If you ever get hit like that, you go below half. Crit rush to another, just knock her down and go back on another. You basically just want to drop their DPS as needed. And watch out for take aim. It takes a while for take aim to go off though, so it gives you a lot of time. It's almost like a break from taking damage. This is kind of tough too. This is right after the 3 archers. I'm going to use my pot now. Tab target one and take him out quick. He's going to go in rage, which is why you want to drop one and not hit both of them at the same time. Let him rage and back off a sec. His rage is up. He's enraged now. He's went big mode. Okay, he's dead. Let's heal up. Let's drop the poison person. Now we can go back on this guy. Just one of them won't kill you, but two of them do have the potential to burst you pretty hard. When he's doing this right there, you can't hurt him. Just gotta wait that for a sec. That does damage and slows you a lot. It's like getting hit with jabs over and over. So watch out for that. This is the last phase. An interesting one too. This one is bugged in many, many, many regards. Some of them are being fixed with the next patch because I've complained a lot about them. And ZeniMax has watched me do this a lot. So this is one of the things that's at least getting fixed. Okay, so two adds spawn. As soon as they spawn, you have to drop one, and you go hide under the other. You have to be careful of a lot of things in here. First of all, his scream hurts you before that bubble actually comes up. That's one of the things that's getting fixed that I've complained about. Again, if you have a shield stack, no problem. Just shield stack until it actually works. If you're stamina and you don't have good burst heal, you're in trouble. Now, I rely on vigor and crit rush sometimes. If I can, I'll crit rush the guy who's putting the shield up just as a way to keep myself alive. I try to save my pot for that as well. But it ticks for 11k. Like, I mean, I survive, you know, not much. Because you also have a dot on you, so you can take two ticks of the enrage and then you're done. You gotta tap out. And that's it. Okay, so now he's doing his thing. I vigored to stay alive. Now we just go on him with overload for a little. He's gonna finish, kill this thing really quick, or else she can actually do some damage to you, because then she'll enrage. So you wanna make sure that dies very fast. Always get rid of that ASAP. I think I got hit by that. Yes, I did. And this guy, he just, that bleed's really annoying. Everything he does is anti-melee. He's very easy to deal with at range. I've learned how to melee him, so I'm going to melee him. Because I just kind of face tank through it. Because I use crit rush so much. And I can kill him quicker. And the quicker I kill him, the sooner I'm out of this place. So here we go. I use Dawnbreaker because I'm not going to need my overload anymore. I plan to kill him by the next time that happens. And if I don't, I'm doing it wrong. See, I got hit by his thing, but I just heal through it. If you CC break that quick enough, it doesn't apply the dot. It's a bug. Don't tell ZeniMax, though. Because I don't want them to fix that shit. Got enough problems holding me back. See, I didn't CC break it in time. Sometimes you can't, though, honestly. Jesus. So there you go. It's a rough arena. It's very tough for melee Stam. But it's very doable. Nude, you son of a bitch. How you doing, man? Welcome. On to the next floor. This one's not bad at all. The tree guys hit hard. This is really just a matter of method. Kill the range, kill the healers. I know everything that spawns here, so I know what I'm facing. These fire guys will put a firestorm up above their head. Make sure you stun them when they do that. That right there. So you want to crit rush to them, bash them, finish everything else. And then check my reward. Okay, Issa. I'm sure it's nothing good. even though I ranked, what, number 6? Okay. This guy spawned, you gotta kill the pillar. Once the pillar's down, you can hit the boss. Usually I overload them, but I used up all my overload charges on the last boss, so I'm actually gonna have to melee this guy, which is really annoying. He does hit very hard. Keep yourself at 100% at all moments. Because he just hits really hard. That's all there is to that. Okay. Three little spiders spawn here. The range guy here. Once you learn things, it helps if you actually end up having to do this arena that much and you know every spawn that's coming, like I do, unfortunately. And I still haven't got what I want. So yeah, two healers here. And the adds dish out damage. Make sure crit surge is up. This time I'll have some overload charges to use on this guy, which is nice. Okay, round 3. See, my burst is so heavy, I can just kill through what healers would heal through. If you do this on some builds, you'll be like, man, my damage sucks if you've watched this. Because believe me, I did this and my damage wasn't this high before, and I had a very good build. It's just, this one is very good. I couldn't see myself doing this any other way now. I really like this build. Especially with a Stam sorc. Gonna rebuff real quick. See, there's the overload proc. Makes your the Molokina proc. It makes your overload cost more, so you get like less shots. But it really doesn't matter. Especially for the way that we're using overload. We don't use it all the time. The only time we do use it, we want to amp up our damage. Again, it would be better if overload was fixed and worked for Stam sorc and it scaled very high. Because then if I did use it the way I am using it now, Stam sorc would do this. It would have the best DPS, better than Magicka sorc, and it should. All right, guys. Hello, welcome everyone. Sorry, I was just making a quick little thing for my YouTube. I can put up later for this build. People have been asking about it for a while. Thank you again for the sub, Spaz. Welcome everybody. Just doing a little Maelstrom action. Brenois, how you doing? Spees, what's up, man? Good to see you guys. Happy Sunday. Oh boy. Dodging Sauls. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm hitting every Saul in the dungeon. Please give me a wrecking blow crit. Not a single one. The danger zone. This stage, guys, I really don't like it. In fact, I really dislike this stage. I always die to the Sols just accumulating damage and dots on me. No matter what happens, that happens. Every time, without fail. Got a little shout out to Roble on that build. Unplanned shout outs. The best ones. Maybe everyone will look at it and say, hey, fix that shit. Why is that shit still broken? He's doing the steam move. Look out for the steam maneuver. Gotcha. Excellent. What's up, it's ninjas? How you doing? Welcome. How am I doing today? Very well. I hope you're all wells. My magic and night play for some reason. Honestly, I think twice born star is good for magicka and stamina. I think it's like the way to go. Twice born, two undaunted pieces, and either agility or whatever the magicka version of those three piece jewelry sets are. I think that build will work. Anybody, anywhere, anytime. Honestly. And PvE, 100%. Because crit is very, very effective in PvE. It's so effective, if you don't gear yourself to it, you may be doing it wrong. That's my opinion, and I'm going with it. I don't know what the Wamasu's doing. I don't think he does either. Pay attention. You might learn something. You lumps. Is that what she calls them? Lumps? I don't know what she says. Going for a ride, and I don't even know what's happening anymore. Please let me break it. fingers. Thanks. You got it. Yeah, I think as far as my armor setup goes, this works for everybody. Any stamina, any whatever. Just from a DPS perspective, all you have to do is sort out your survival, honestly. Which, every class has a way to go about survival. Some better than others. Mine comes from damage. Which is nice from a DPS perspective. It's like, amp your DPS and you have better survival. You know, there are things to consider in there where that's... where there's issues with that. Come the fuck on. She's having a heart attack. It's an addiction. It's okay. It's going well so far. Don't be a Debbie Downer. Or Downey Debner. I wanted to come make a content for video. That's all. Gotta give the people what they want. Right? I think my crit surge faded. Careful with that. Okay, my crit surge not working still. Gonna die. Close one. See that big crit surge heal? That is what I am talking about. I like to use Vigor a lot in this stage because this boss hits really hard. Crit surging across the room buys you some time in between her hits to kill the adds, which is a desirable thing. Gotta get rid of those adds, the ranged adds. No good. What sets am I using? I just went through it, Dick in a Box. You'll be able to see it on my YouTube. Just went through it. Twiceborn Star, 3-piece agility, 2-piece Molag Kina, Maelstrom weapon. That's what I'm using. It will be on the tube. For all the boobs. I want to run this build. You make it look so easy. I'm sorry. So yeah, for this stage, you just kill the adds. The beginning's pretty easy. You want to kill those balls when you can, or they go invulnerable like that. No big deal. You just have to come back to them in a little bit. Don't let them stack up though, because they keep coming. Here's a new one. Take him out. And just keep making passes at that ball. Eventually his time will be up and he'll be killable. His time is about up. That one just went down. His time's up. Take the adds out first. New ball. Rotate light attacks, wrecking blows, backpedal with crit rush. That's your general DPS combo. Throw in a bow and you can make sure to rebuff all the time. Keep your stam up with heavy attacks. Anytime you get a break with mobs, weave in heavy attacks to recover stamina instead. Make sure you kill stuff every 10 seconds to keep battle rush up. See battle rush down there on my buff bar.